Hello everyone, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we are going to talk about the topic saprophytic bacteria. This is a mode of nutrition that is used or performed by different bacteria. We know about other different modes like photoautotrophic bacteria, which uses light as a source of energy in order to prepare their food. Next, we know about chemoautotrophic bacteria, which uses chemical compounds as a source of their energy in order to prepare food. Now, here we are going to talk about the saprophytic bacteria. So, what are these? Saprophytic bacteria are basically free living bacteria, correct? So, in nature, they are the free living type of bacteria which are found. Their source of energy or their source of food is it obtains food from organic remains. So, this is very important. They take their food from the dead remained part of the plants and animals and other products. For example, it uses the dead parts of plants, animals. It uses different carbohydrate sources like rice, then jams, jellies. So these uses these type of bacteria, saprophytic bacteria, they uses these type of food or the rotten materials as a source of energy. Now, there are different types of reactions followed by these type of bacteria in order to obtain their food. For example, the first of all is fermentation. So, what is fermentation? Fermentation is an anaerobic process. That means it does not require oxygen. So, anaerobic breakdown of carbohydrates is known as fermentation. So, these bacteria, when it ferments or performs the breakdown of carbohydrates in the absence of oxygen, so this process is known as fermentation. The next process is known as putrefaction. Okay, it is known as putrefaction. So what is this? This is also another anaerobic process in which breakdown of proteins happen. So in fermentation, it is the anaerobic breakdown of carbohydrates, whereas in putrefaction, it is the anaerobic breakdown of proteins. There is another process which is now an aerobic process. So, the aerobic breakdown of organic compounds is known as decay. So, this is the chemical reaction because of which the food materials in our home and our daily uses, these materials like bread, rice and all these things which we are using daily are getting rotten because of this reaction. Okay, this is a aerobic process in which the breakdown of organic compounds take place. Now, let us take a look on the different harmful activities performed by these type of saprophytic bacteria. So, what are the different harmful activities? First of all, we are discussing spoilage of foodstuff. So, it is responsible. So, these bacteria are responsible for the damaging the normal food which we are using in our household. It is responsible for causing food poisoning. So, it is one of the common diseases which we see all around, which is very common in case of human beings. So, food poisoning, this results because if we have damaged or decayed food, and this is performed by the saprophytic bacteria. It causes denitrification of soil. So, because of this denitrification, the nitrogen as a source of nutrient for the plants decreases. So, it causes denitrification, and after denitrification, this form of nitrogen cannot be used by the plants as a source of their nutrient. So, it is very harmful for the plants. Next is, it causes deterioration of the household articles. For example, it causes deterioration of leather, wood, fibers. So, these household articles are deteriorated by these type of saprophytic bacteria. So, these are the harmful activities we have discussed. Now, let us take a look on the different useful activities of this type of saprophytic bacteria. So, very, very importantly, they help in cleaning the dead and the organic waste. So, we can understand that organisms like plants, animals, all living organisms die after a certain period of time. So, after their death, these are the organisms that is saprophytic bacteria. They help in cleaning the earth from these dead organisms and they get rid of this dead organic matter. So, let's imagine a condition if these saprophytic bacteria were not present. So, what would have happened? all these organisms which are dying every day, every minute. So these organisms would have stayed on Earth and it wouldn't have rotted, and you can understand what a mess it would have become. So they have been cleaning the dead and the dead organic remains. They help in release of raw materials. Very important that after decaying, it breaks down the organic compounds, or it releases the raw materials from which the plant or the organism have initially used it during its lifetime. So it helps in recycling of the nutrients. So this is a very important process. Without the these type of saprophytic bacteria, the nutrients which are mostly present on the earth, it wouldn't have come back. So slowly and steadily the nutrient content would have reduced. So it helps in the releasing of raw materials and helps in reutilization. That is, again, these things are used by the new upcoming organisms. It is known as nature's scavenger. So we can now very well understand why they are known as nature's scavengers, because they help in cleaning up the dead or decaying parts, dead organic matters of plants and animals. So they are known as nature's scavengers. They importantly take part in forming of cheese, curd, etc. So they help in converting milk into these type of products like cheese, curd, yogurt, so which we are using every day. So saprophytic bacteria are responsible for these type of conversions. Most importantly, they are also used for making alcohols and organic acid synthesis. So these are very useful in our day-to-day life. Like here, alcohol we use for our daily chemical reactions in our laboratories, and also organic acids, it's used for cleaning and other chemical reactions in everyday. It helps in biodegradation of the organic pollutants. Very importantly, for example, we hear in news mostly that there is a spillage that have occurred in the oceans. Now, how to remove these type of oils? So there's a bacteria known as Pseudomonas. They can clear these spillage or these organic pollutants from the oceans. We know due to these type of spillage, there's a death of a lot number of aquatic animals and plants. So they help in the biodegradation of the organic pollutants. So in this video, we have talked about a nutrition type, which is known as saprophytic nutrition. We have discussed what is saprophytic nutrition. We have discovered some of the harmful and useful activities of these type of saprophytic bacteria. So I hope you have liked this video. Thank you.